With Florida's recent hurricanes and the winter season upon us, us, as well as many of you guys, have already or are about to experience some power outages. So we wanted to make this video kind of showing you guys what you can power with a power station and for just how long to kind of help you guys determine what power station will suit your needs. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Today we're going to be looking at the Anker F3800 plus one expansion battery as our example unit. Videos on this unit tend to do pretty well. A lot of you guys ask questions about it and show interest in it, so we thought it would be a good example unit for this video. Now when a hurricane or an emergency happens, most people aren't trying to cook a turkey dinner. You're just trying to keep the essentials running. A unit like this allows you to use it outside of a power outage for some pretty intense things, but it also just does the bare necessities pretty well. And just a heads up, if you're trying to run an air conditioner or some sort of heat during said outage, this is not the video for you. Heat and air conditioning are major power consumers. If you live somewhere where you're gonna need air conditioning during an outage, make sure you have some fans or something. And if you live somewhere where you're gonna need some heat, you need like a wood burning stove or a good gas burning appliance, because running a furnace or an air conditioner, our heat pump uses about 2,500 watts, and a heat pump won't heat your whole house. It'll heat a little area or cool a little area. But if you're trying to do this stuff with electricity, you're just gonna be wasting so much power. We're gonna need to make another video. This is about portable power. You're looking for something that's like full home backup. It feels like, at least where we live, most of the power outages happen overnight. Most of the time, I wake up and the power's out. So that's exactly where we started today's test. So after dragging myself out of bed, I wheeled the Anker F3800 plus one expansion battery into the kitchen. I'm trying to give you guys a real bare bones example here, not have it plugged into like a transfer switch or anything. This is just like real raw, having a unit for emergencies. Plug the fridge into it. Go ahead, turn that thing on. The fridge does a quick cycle, spikes about 400, and then starts drawing a constant 30 watts. We actually just released an entire video on how much power a fridge uses. If you guys are interested in it, we will leave links to that down below. But we know kind of what to expect from that. So the F3800 should be plenty. Went ahead, fumbled with the Wi-Fi, trying to get that turned off to save as much power as possible. Then we went ahead and plugged in the Wi-Fi router. Maybe you don't have cell service where you live. Maybe you're gonna work from home and you need the Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi routers have been pulled as one of the most important things to you guys during an outage, so we decided to run it. And our Wi-Fi router uses about 12 watts of power per hour, so not super power intensive. Both the fridge and the Wi-Fi router we're gonna leave out of the updated kind of usage equations we do, and we're just gonna add these back in at the end because they're gonna be running the whole time. So moving on with the example, now you need to see. In real life, I actually don't. I fumble around in the dark because I'm trying to conserve as much power as possible. But to show you guys just how far you can push these units, we went ahead and plugged in 3 9-watt light bulbs and let them rip for a full hour. That's like having one in the kitchen, one in the bathroom, and one in your bedroom. It's a pretty good amount of light. And also, it's worth noting, most light bulbs nowadays take like 4 watts of power, maybe. So the fact that we used a 9-watt light bulb is double what you really should be using per bulb. Coffee, it's a necessity. 908 watts is what our coffee maker uses, but it only needs power for about 5 minutes long. As soon as that coffee's brewed, I would unplug it because the warmer underneath is gonna consume power. You don't wanna waste it if you don't have to, but you need that coffee. So coffee, and then you know what? To be honest, I'm making a bagel before I leave. So we threw some toast in the toaster. Our toaster uses about 835 watts. Again, you're using it for maybe 3 minutes, so not a whole lot of power used there. And bam, breakfast is served. And so after an hour, you should definitely have your shit together. You should be ready to start your day. You should be able to turn those lights off. And so at this point, not including the fridge or the router, we've used about 143.5 watt hours. And after that first hour has come and gone, the rest of the day gets kind of weird. Some people go to work, some people work from home. We're pretending that it's the middle of a disaster or a snowstorm, so maybe you can't go to work, maybe you have to work from home. Regardless, we're gonna pretend that you were home for the day. So we went ahead and plugged in my computer. Uses about 65 watts of power per hour. It does fluctuate a bit depending on what it's doing, but that's roughly what it uses. And we basically let that thing run for 8 hours. Now that could be exchanged for all kinds of things. 65 watts could be 2 fans. Our fans use just over 30 watts of power. So you could not have a TV or a computer on. You could just be using that same power to run 2 fans to keep you cool inside your house. You could have the TV on, maybe you're watching the news, maybe you really are at home working. Whatever it is, 65 watts. We're using that for about 8 hours. We also plugged in one of those 9-watt lights for about 1 hour. That kind of simulates like charging your phone up or something like that. It's not a crazy amount of power, but I wanted to just shove that extra little bonus in there. But you, at this point, the sun should be out enough that you don't need lights on in your house. At lunch, personally, I would make a salad or try to barbecue something, but not everybody has that luxury. So we went ahead and used the microwave for a total of 4 minutes. The microwave is honestly not the worst. Like it takes 1400 watts, but you're only running it for about 4 minutes. So it really breaks down to not that much power. And it's the most realistic way for you to just quickly heat something up or, you know, heat up leftovers or whatever, if that's what you have to do. So we ran that for 4 minutes, and that was basically all the power that we tried to consume during this 8-hour workday. And so after the full 8-hour workday, we're about 622 watt hours of usage. That's running the computer for 8 hours, that light bulb for 1 hour, and then 4 minutes of microwaving. Not a whole lot used throughout the day. Obviously the fridge and the Wi-Fi router are still going. We just haven't added them in yet. And now that the workday's over, what's the average person going to do when they get home? I don't know. Maybe you were already home. Maybe you transfer from your computer to your TV to watch the news to see what's going on in the world, when your power is going to come back or what the deal is. Maybe you just have been watching TV the whole day and you never moved. Regardless, we decided to run the next 5 hours as if you came home. Maybe you have the TV on for your kid. Who knows? We left the computer running for another 5 hour time period. And we ran 3 of those 9-watt lights for 5 hours. So again, it's like 27 watts an hour just in lights. That could be a fan that's running. If you never use your computer or TV this whole day, you could take all that power that we're saying we're consuming and you could have put that towards actually making yourself some decent food throughout the day if you weren't using a ton of power elsewhere. Like, all these numbers are exchangeable, but I will say at this point, you can see the power is not coming back. It is a smart time to be conscious of your usage. If you're using as much power as we kind of have, I wouldn't use anything else to cook. I would try to order in or barbecue or make a salad or do something. Do something that isn't using power to do it. Point is, after another boring 5 hours, we've used about 460 watt hours and it is bedtime. Now, we left the Wi-Fi router plugged in overnight. If you didn't have service where you lived or you relied on that Wi-Fi for communication, you probably want that plugged in so you can get notified of whatever's going on or talk to people or whatever. But now that you're to bed, it's just the fridge and the Wi-Fi router carrying you on throughout the night. And when we woke up in the morning, the F3800 was at 36%. Which was kind of surprising. It feels like it lost a lot of power during the night and we didn't really do a whole lot. It felt like during the day, the percentage was going down and it felt normal. And then I woke up and it's like, how did it get to this percent? But there's a few reasons that it did do this. And the first one, something that we actually have just now experienced for the first time to such a dramatic level that we're gonna start incorporating it as a test in all of our future videos, is idle consumption. So basically, every power station carries power in DC. It then, when you use the plugs, it converts it to AC and puts it to the plugs so it's ready to be used. But the power station's actually using power to do the conversion process and get it ready to go, even if you're not using it. So, based on our math, this thing uses almost 79 watts per hour just idling, just getting the plugs ready to go. Another way that you can kind of look at this is right now we have the expansion battery unplugged. This is just the F3800 reading. Says 93% time remaining, 2.1 days. We're running absolutely no load. There's nothing plugged in, but the inverter is turned on. And so 93% of 3,800 watt hours is like 35 something. If you divide that by 48 hours, it says it's basically going to use 73 or something like that watts per hour just doing nothing, just sitting here. So that's actually really close to what our experiment showed, which is just a fact of life. Just goes to show you, like, if you're not running something, just be cautious of how much time you need these things on for. Or more efficiently, if you get like a DC fridge, you can run it off the little 12 volt socket right here that doesn't use this inverter. You're not wasting the power going from DC to AC. Instead, you're just giving off direct DC current and it doesn't take anything to convert it. So it'll just sit here idling at a much more efficient rate. You're only going to use power when you're actually using it. That's how I think a lot of people expect these things to work. And that's what I would do if I was in a severe outage. I'd put all my stuff in a DC fridge that I use for camping and just run it like that. You also have to take into account things like the computer. It does fluctuate quite a bit depending on what you're doing. If for example, that timer we had going was a YouTube video. When the ads popped up, the usage spiked because it's pulling new information from the internet It's using different colors, it's doing all kinds of stuff, sounds, and it just basically uses a ton of more power. So that's not a perfect 65, it does fluctuate quite a bit. And so that's the results after 24 hours. The average outage in the United States is 6 hours. At this point, you could charge it with solar, you could charge it with a generator, assuming you don't have any power. You could have more expansion batteries just kind of ready to go. Personally, I'd be a lot stingier if I were in an outage. I would be able to actually make an F3800 run my essentials at home, not showing off for a test, for over a day. So in lamest terms, I'll say I can get one F3800 to last me 1 day. That means basically every expansion battery will add on one more day. I would know that I could go ahead and basically get 2 expansion batteries, and that would last me a total of 3 full days in case of an outage. And if you ever wanted to upgrade in the future, you can always add more. The F3800s are pretty expandable. Batteries stack really nicely on top and they don't take up much extra space, so it's actually pretty easy to store them. But that's kind of where you'd be at with using, honestly, an excessive amount of power all day and this setup. If you were to just use this setup just to keep your fridge and your Wi-Fi and like lights for a matter of minutes at a time, 5 minutes here, 10 minutes there, charge your phone, whatever, you could make it last a couple days. We just wanted to show you the extreme end of actually like doing stuff inside of your home. That is it. Hopefully you guys found some sort of information in this video helpful. If you're trying to learn, if you don't understand some of the things we talked about or whatever, we do have a whole course. We'll leave a link to it down below that can hopefully help you guys kind of understand what might be best for your needs. Otherwise, check out some other videos. We've reviewed a ton of products on the channel. That is all we got for you guys today. I'll catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.